Each day this Easter, journey with Leigh Road Baptist in an online immersive journey through the first Holy Week. With short prayers and reflections led by Andrew Cowley and footage from the LUMO video series, every day from Palm Sunday to Easter Day.
And Jesus is in the tomb. The crucifixion has happened, the resurrection is yet to come. Let's watch this next video.
It was preparation day, that is, the day before the Sabbath. So as evening approached, Joseph of Arimathea, a prominent member of the council, who was himself waiting for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for Jesus' body. Pilate was surprised to hear that he was already dead. Summoning the centurion, he asked him if Jesus had already died. When he learnt from the centurion that it was so, he gave the body to Joseph. So Joseph bought some linen cloth, took down the body, wrapped it in the linen, and placed it in a tomb cut out of rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where he was laid. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go. Tell his disciples and Peter, he is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3 to 4, the Apostle Paul writes of the things that happened in these days as being of first importance, that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the Scriptures. Jesus' death, his burial and resurrection changed the course of history forever. These events are the foundation of our faith today. Jesus' death paid the penalty for our sins and wrongdoing, and his resurrection gave us an eternal promise that we too can live with him forever in a new heaven and a new earth. While our time here on this earth is fleeting, his kingdom is not its forever. No more pain. No more suffering, no more persecution. We can look to his eternal kingdom with hope and with peace, knowing that this Easter, all that Christ has done for us at Calvary. Let's take a moment on this unusual day to reflect on the empty tomb and the triumph that Jesus has overcome death. So let's pray. Lord God, on the Sabbath, Jesus rested. He was in the grave. He'd finished his work. To most people's eyes, it looked as if it was all over. He was dead and buried. But only as a seed dies when it is planted in the earth, not to decay, but to spring into new life. Teach us to take security from when we are afraid. Teach us that death is not the end, Teach us to hope in you always, and in the resurrection, and in the making of all things new. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Each day this Easter, journey with Leigh Road Baptist in an online immersive journey through the first Holy Week. With short prayers and reflections led by Andrew Cowley, and footage from the LUMO video series, every day from Palm Sunday to Easter Day.